Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can use the Revert To feature to go back to earlier versions of your documents. You can use this to get back items that you've deleted from the documents or things that you've changed. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. You can find out more at MACMOST.com/Patreon. Join us and get exclusive content. So a lot of Mac users don't even know this exists. When you're working in apps like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, every time you save, you're saving a version of that document and you can go back and look at older versions. So say if you're writing something and you delete a paragraph and a few days later you want to go back and recover that paragraph, you can. Let me show you how. So let's start from scratch here and create a blank document in Pages. I'm going to add some text to it. Now that I've done all this work, probably a good idea for me to save the document. I can use File, Save, or Command S to save it. Since this is the first time I'm saving the document, it's going to prompt me for a name and location. Now I'm going to type another line. Now that I've done some work, I want to save it again. So I'm going to use Command S again. Now I'm going to type a third line. Now that my document is getting really long, I'm going to make sure I'm saving it every once in a while. So Command S again, and then a fourth line. So now I have four lines in the document. And it seems like I have a normal document here where I've simply saved the document and if I would open it again I would get back to these four lines of text. But there's actually a lot more going on because every time I've saved a version of the document and I can revert to any of those versions. If I go to File, I can see Revert To, and there's a few things there. I've got Last Saved. Now since I haven't saved yet after typing the fourth line, I can jump right back to the last saved version. Could also go to Browse All Versions. Let's go to that. And you're going to go into an interface that looks a lot like Time Machine. On the left you have the current document. And on the right you have this stack of old versions. And you can see the most recent saved version only has three lines. I can use these arrows here to go back to previous versions. So there's one with two lines, there's with one line, and there's the original version there. I can choose any one of these and use the Restore button. And what will happen is I'll restore to this version of the document. So I can hit Restore and now I'm back to a version of the document that doesn't have the fourth line. Now even if you know how to use this, there's a lot more functionality here. For instance, what happened to that fourth line? Well, it turns out I could go to Revert To, Browse All Versions, and it actually saved that version. So if you want to revert back to before you did the Revert To, you can. Which makes it a nice safe operation to do. In case you make a mistake, you can actually go back to this one. Another thing you can do is you can copy and paste between these. I can click here on this document. You can see it enlarges it, but I'm still in this mode here where I've got Done and Restore and I have the other versions back here. But I can actually work in the document. So I can add new stuff. You can see there's a cursor. I can select things. I can also click here and enlarge this. Now you may just use this to get a better view of the version of the document, but you could also select something, copy it with Command C, go over here to this version, and paste it in. That's right, you can work on the document while you're in this mode. Another thing you could do is you can hold the Option key and notice the Restore button here changes to Restore a Copy. So I can keep this current version but save this version out as a copy of the document. A few other things going on. One is you've got this timeline here on the right, which since I just started working on this document, there's not much there. But if I had been revising this document for months, I could easily jump back to an earlier version. So maybe if I did something in my first draft and I want to bring it back, I could easily jump 2-3 months back and find it. Another thing to note is that the file sizes are going to remain under control because it's not saving a completely new file each time. It's saving changes. So you have your current document with everything there, but it remembers what changes there were between that and the last revision, and the revision before that and before that. So instead of having 10 different copies of the same file, it's actually going to have one copy of the file and then the changes going back in time. So actually the file sizes stay quite small. Now if you save a document like this and you close it and then you go to open it again, so I'll open Recent, I've got it here, and if I start working on the document, I'll just hit Return here. I'll notice that now I have Last Opened. And in fact, if I start working here and I hit Save and then I start working again, now if I go here I have three options. I've got the Last Saved version, I have the Last
open version. So I can revert all the way back to the point where I opened it. Even if I've saved a dozen times, I can jump back to when I opened the file this morning. And I can go to browse all versions to see everything. And this works in more places than just Pages. For instance, in Keynote, you've got revert to there as well. And it works exactly the same way. And also in Numbers, you've got it there as well. And it's not just those three apps. For instance, you can use it in TextEdit. So TextEdit also has those. And technically, this is available for lots of other apps to use. One example of a third-party app that has implemented it is Pixelmator. So here I have a document with just some squiggles in it. And I can go to revert to, and there's last save, last open, browse all versions.
Okay, so I'm sure you can see how handy a feature this is. But here's what I recommend. Don't wait till the first time you really need this to use it. Practice right now. So open up a document in Pages, or maybe if you use Numbers more, use that. And just create a sample document, save a bunch of times, close the document, open the document, use the revert to feature, see how it works. So the first time you really need it, you've already got some experience using it.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.